the weed, I got a story to tell. A couple years ago, it was Christmas night back in my hometown, Wells. The snowfall about an inch an hour, and on the road, just our pickup truck and snow plows. After familial obligations, me and my man Phil met up to start blazing. Around 8, sparked the backwoods on the back roads. The wind chill blew the snow like Satchmo. I asked, how was your Christmas? He said it sucked. I asked why. He said, man, my sister's fucked. If that slut died tonight, it wouldn't be enough. I asked for an explanation. He just took another puff. He handed it to me. I told him, mine wasn't better. I just got a couple corny-ass sweaters, and my family embarrassed me because apparently getting arrested twice in a month is worthy of a parody. Just then, turned on to Bear's Den, saw a whip with a woman and a kid in it in a ditch. A Volkswagen the color of cocaine with the front end buried inside of a snowbank. The temperature's near zero, man, it isn't May, and no reception out here to call AAA. It's safe to say if Phil and I hadn't drove by, this lady and her son would have frozen and died. We put the woods in the ashtray, stopped the truck, put the gloves on, hopped out of the shit and walked that way. We asked if we could help. She said, oh, thank God, yes, she looked blazed herself. Her son shivered in the passenger wearing his seatbelt. He looked to be about 12. We said, no prob. Her son said, you're our guardian angels. We laughed and moved the truck at an angle. We hooked the chains up and put them in drive. We had them out faster than a first pitch pop fly. It was all thank yous and hugging. Could have sworn I smelled rum on the breath of the woman. Nonetheless, gave her son a high five, popped up in the truck, and then we drove into the night. Never told anybody about the good deeds of the two dudes in hoodies. I wish the story ended there. I woke the next morning with the sun, reflecting off the snow in the yard out front. I felt fine in my flannel sheets. The day after a snowstorm tends to bring clarity. And a shitload of shoveling. I was still living at the home that my mother's in. I pulled my covers off, I felt quite alive as I reached for my phone, which I had on silent. And this was years ago now, but I recall I saw 16 texts, 31 missed calls. I knew something was awry. I ran downstairs, mom, tears in her eyes and her mouth agape, staring at the TV.